China Offshore Oil Corporation that was contracted to develop Kingfisher oil field in Buhuka landing site in Chikube district recently subcontracted another Chinese company known as the Qing Oil Field Construction Group to construct a feeder pipeline that will transport crude oil from oil wells to a central processing facility that will be set up in Kabale Industrial Area. However, during the monitoring and supervision exercise conducted by a team of Petroleum Authority of Uganda, led by the Executive Director, Ernest Robondo, it was discovered that the subcontractors have not given jobs to local welders. Among other conditions, the Qing was asked to hire local subcontractors to do the trenching and also train local welders.
Emirimu gigenze maso naye ebirala byetutunuulidde nga tuli wano kwe kuba nti twagala kulaba ba Ugandan contractors, twagala kulaba company enzaaliranwa bana Uganda nga bali wano bali involved. Nekira twagala kulaba bana Uganda kubanga government etaddemu efforts nyingi ng'ekolagana ne companies okulaba nti bana Uganda bafuna training okutendekebwa mu welding na buli kimu katetoka tutendeke bantu basigaleye ebbali.
Robondo also tasked them to employ the locals in the area to do casual work before approving their construction permit.
Taking us around, thank you for starting to bring the things. We hope you can start work on the ground when we have put everything in order. And you can get more things. We are interested in Ugandans and Ugandan companies doing more of the work. But this work is once. You probably will not lay another pipeline. So once it is finished, it's finished.
No kuterezebwa era tubitaddeko eriiso joji nga tukakasa nti bigenda kuterezebwa bulungi era tugenda bigoberera paka nga buli kimu kiteredde tulabe nti Uganda ne bana Uganda project is nezamafuta ddala bazifunamu ate nga ddala zaabwe.
Alex Nyombi, an officer for the Petroleum Authority, hopes that once they make things right, they'll be granted an operation license. And it will also reduce unemployment in the country.
Basinze okufuna training zizinera abantu bavudde mu region wano tebavudde wala. So tusuubira nti kasita bino binaterezebwa. Waliwo ku project anaje tubadde kutulabye ba welders abava mu region. Waliwo abava mu Pakwa, Chinoya, Bulisa, ne Hoima. Tusuubira na wano kijja kubera.
We have the competent and the skilled welder to do this work. Firstly, we prepared 10 welders for the starting work.
So it will be important to know who is going to dig the trench also.
Okay.
The process of identifying the person, the company, then we know the company and we work with them. I think they will also be in the camp. They'll be living here. Well, they might have their own camp, but that's a detail.
Okay.
The Vice President of Sinok Uganda advised the subcontractors to set up a working plan and requirements so that work can start as soon as possible.
Clear plan.
Yes.
We will use the local welders, you know, to replace Chinese welders, you know, for the work. You must make a really clear plan. And according to the plan, you make your training programs. You need to have a target. You cannot say that, okay, we don't know. Depending on the welders, the skills of welders, then not accept.
The Executive Director of Petroleum Authority of Uganda, Ernest Rubondo, also visited the waste management plant that is under construction by Luwero Industries Limited. He tasked them to speed up the remaining works that include a weigh bridge. Uganda expects to have its first commercial oil production in 2025. Report compiled by Ambrose Nwagaba Katoto.